Hello everyone, welcome back to Chenda DIY. And today's video, I'll be showing you how to crochet the flower square cardigan. It is really easy pattern and friendly for beginners. And for this flower cardigan, I made for size small. And in this tutorial, I also showing you how to make the cardigan more bigger or longer for any size. Okay, now without further ado, let's get started. First thing first, we are start working from the flower square. For the flower square pattern and tutorial, you can find it in my previous video. Or you can click the link in the description below to watch this flower square tutorial. For my part 1 video or this flower square tutorial, I also showing you how to join the square together. And in this part 2, I just showing you the pattern of the cardigan, the measurement, and how to attach each part of the cardigan together. And for the last part is how to crochet the edges around the cardigan. And this is the back part of the cardigan. For the length of my cardigan, it is equal 19 inches. And for the width or the height of my cardigan, it is equal 14 inches. So for this back panel, I have 48 squares in total. For one horizontal line, I have 8 squares and I make 6 horizontal lines. For you guys that want to make bigger size, you can add more rows of the square. Or if you want to make your cardigan more longer, you can add more square below until you got your desired fit. For the measurement or the length of the cardigan, you just make it bigger than your shoulder measurement. If you want it more bigger or like an oversized cardigan, you just add more squares to make it bigger than your shoulder measurement. And next, for the front part of my cardigan, I have 15 squares in total. For one horizontal line, I have 3 squares and I make 5 horizontal lines. Actually, for the both front part and the back part of the cardigan, you must have the same number of the row of the square or the same number of the width of the cardigan. But for this front part, the reason why I make it only 5 lines, because for one last line of the square, we keep it for attach the front part and the back part of the cardigan together. So for this back panel, I have 8 rows of the square. For front panel, I make 3 rows of the square for each side, and I still have 2 rows at the middle. It is for the neckline part. You can leave 1 row or 2 rows or 3 rows at the middle. It's up to the size of the cardigan that you made. And next, I'm gonna show you how to attach this front part with the back part of the cardigan together by using the same method of joining the square like I showed you in the previous video or part 1. After you have made a flower and then chain 4. And next, you always start joining the corner with the corner. So I'm start joining the corner of this flower square with the other corner of the back panel, as you can see. And then using the same pattern or method like the part 1. After you have attached the corner or one side of the square, and for this side, you just make normal chain 6 space until you reach the corner. And after after you reach the corner, chain 4 and then start joining the corner with the other corner of the front panel again. Continue attach both parts together until you reach the other corner. And after you reach the other corner, which is the fourth corner, and then continue make normal chain 6 space until you reach the end of the row. After you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch into the single crochet stitch, chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what it looks like. As you can see, we use this one square to attach the back panel and the front panel of the cardigan together. And for the next square, you just repeat the same thing by always start joining the square from the corner. Attach chain 6 space with chain 6 space, corner of the square with the other corner of the square. And now I'm gonna show you how I join in this square. And this is what it looks like after I have attached the second square. And for the third square, you just repeat the same thing like the second square. Turn your work like this, and this is what it looks like. And for the other side, you just repeat the same thing like this first side, then we meet you back again. And next, for the sleeves, I have 24 squares in total. For one horizontal line, I have 6 squares and I make 4 horizontal lines. For these 4 horizontal lines, it is the length of my sleeves. If you guys want your sleeve more longer, you can add more rows of the square. And for the width of the sleeves or the measurement around my arm, I make it only 4 rows or 4 lines. And for one last line, I will use it for attach the sleeve together. Like I said, if you guys want your sleeve more longer or bigger, you just add more squares. And after you have attached the front panel with the back panel together, and next, we are going to attach the sleeve with this both panel by using the same method like we attached the front panel and the back panel together. And next, turn your cardigan like this, and this is what it looks like. And for the next part, you just attach this side of the cardigan. And as you can see, I already used one square to attach the sleeve together. And for the other side, I already attached them. And this is what it should look like. And as you can see, for this underarm part, I have 5 corners of the square joining together. And after you have attached the sleeves, and next, I'm gonna show you how to crochet the edges around the sleeves. To begin, you can attach the yarn into any corner of the square. And next, for row 1, chain 7. After you got 7 chains, then make slip stitch into the next chain space, which is the chain 6 space. After you have made slip stitch, and then chain 6. And then make slip stitch into the next chain 6 space. After you have made slip stitch, and now we are reached the corner of the square again. Remember, when you reach the corner of the square, you have to make 7 chains. After you got 7 chains, then make slip stitch into this corner stitch. After you have made slip stitch, and now you still have another corner of the square, so chain 7 again. And then make slip stitch into the next chain 6 space. And now you reach the chain 6 space, then you just make only 6 chains. And make slip stitch into the next chain 6 space. And now you reach the corner of the square again. Like I said, when you reach the corner of the square, you have to chain 7 and make slip stitch into the corner stitch. Keep repeating this around until you have one last chain space, then I will meet you back again. And after you have one last chain space, then chain 3. After you got 3 chains, then we are going to make the bulk crochet into this loop where we attach the yarn. Yarn over, insert the hook into the loop. Yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook. Then yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. And this is what it looks like. As you can see, your loop is at the middle of the chain space. It is what we want it to be. And next, for row 2, chain 6. After you got 6 chains, then make slip stitch into the next chain space. After you have made slip stitch, then keep repeating this by chain 6 and make slip stitch into the next chain space. Repeat around until you have one last chain space, then I will meet you back again. And after you have one last chain space, then chain 3. And after you got 3 chains, then make double crochet into this double crochet stitch of the row below. After you have made a double crochet, and this is what it looks like. And for the next row, you just repeat row 2 until you reach row 4. Then I will meet you back again. And after you reach row 4, and this is what it looks like. If you guys want your edge more longer, you can add more rows. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. For the remaining yarn, you can weave in into the back side of the sleeves. And now we are done. This is what it looks like. Please repeat the same thing to the other sleeves. And next, we are going to crochet the edges around this neckline and around this bottom of the cardigan. To begin, we are start working from the corner of the cardigan, which is also the corner of the square. Attach the yarn. For row 1, chain 6. Then make slip stitch into the next chain space. Then chain 6 again and make slip stitch into the next chain space. And now you reach the corner, then chain 7. And make slip stitch into the corner stitch. Then chain 7 again and make slip stitch into the next chain space. And next, chain 6 and make slip stitch into the next chain space. Keep repeating this around until you have one last chain space. Then I will meet you back again. After you have one last chain space, then chain 3. And next, make the double crochet into the same loop where we attach the yarn. After you have made a double crochet, next for row 2, chain 6. Then make slip stitch into the next chain space. Keep repeating this by chain 6, make slip stitch into the next chain space. Repeat around until you have one last chain space, then I will meet you back again. And after you have one last chain space, then chain 3. And then make the double crochet into the double crochet stitch of the row below. And after you have made a double crochet, and this is what it looks like. If you guys want your edges more longer, you can add more rows. For the remaining yarn, please use darning needle to weave in into the back side or the wrong side of the cardigan. And now we are done, crochet the edges around the cardigan, and this is what it looks like. Finally, your flower square cardigan is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Subscribe to my channel and don't forget to follow me on my social media. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.